Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk about how to set up a drip irrigation system, or really the basics of one, give you some ideas on how to design your own, and show you my drip system as an example. So at the very basic level, you would need a water source, usually a spigot, and you need a filter. The one I have is an inline filter, but you don't have to use an inline filter. Below that, you would need a pressure reducer. And then your your main line, usually this is like half-inch tubing, so that would attach there. And on the end, you'd have like a little terminator. And then you would need to connect the main line to your drip emitter. So that's normally done with quarter-inch tubing. So this would come out like that. Well, it doesn't have to be two, it could be just one. But it would attach to an emitter, and that would stake next to your plant. So when you turn the water on, it sends water to all the emitters that are attached. Connections are made with barbed fittings, quarter inch, and use a tool to just kind of give them. Like say this is the half inch tubing. Punch a hole in it with a special tool, and then you would insert a barb connector. And if you're doing just one line, you would just use a single connector. One end would stick in there, and the other end would attach to your poly tubing. Or if you wanted to do two lines, you could use a T connector. And so the poly tubing would connect to each end. So that was how I designed my first one. I had T connector with lines on each side to my plants with one emitter. So basically, if you're going to design your own, there some things to consider. First, you need to look at how much grow space you have to set up your system, the number of plants and type of plants. I grow peppers mostly, so my example fits the model for the number of plants I'm growing. The spacing between plants, and that is more determined by the type, depending on how big the plants get, and your budget. What I recommend doing is sketch out your system with all these factors considered, and then determine what parts you need and go to somewhere that sells drip parts and see how much it will cost to buy all of these. And then the next thing I recommend is to find a kit that approximates what you're doing. I use Drip Depot. I'm an affiliate of theirs, so the link I have in the description. If you buy something through there, I'll earn a commission. But I've recommended them long before I became an affiliate. They're just a good company. But you don't have to use them. There are other drip companies, and some of the big box stores have kits. So I encourage you to sketch out your system based on your space and your requirements, and then look at the number of parts you need. These are things like how much tubing, and also the number of like barb connectors or whatever you use to connect your quarter inch line, number of half inch connectors. I like the perma-loc. They work really well. And things like your pressure reducer, filter, and also I recommend a timer to turn your system on and off, and also a adapter for the spigot. I'm sure it's like a little Y adapter, and they have a little individual shut off, but your drip system would connect to that, and then this other side allows you to use your water hose independently of your drip system. So those are really, you can get those for like $5 or $6. Let me give you a quick overview of how I designed my system. So from the, and this is how I initially designed it. I made some upgrades, but so I had the filter, pressure reducer, my timer was above all of that. So I did two rows, so I kind of went down like that, and then I did a little elbow, it's one row, and a T adapter there, another row. And the rows were about 25 feet long, but this is just showing kind of the overview. Put barbed tees. Of course, I had terminators on the end. And then I used quarter inch tubing on and one drip emitter per plant. So. So in this scenario, I needed, you know, these essential parts and one, two, three, however many plants. I think last year I had about 60 plants. So, like, you just need to figure out how much of what you need. But so I had barbed tee connectors, I had drip emitters, and I used the 1/2 gallon per hour, but you can use faster rate ones. You just, if you use faster ones, you just run it for less time. You kind of have to kind of test run to see how long it takes to run through. Faster emitter, the less time you need, but the 1/2 gallon per hour worked fine. So you determine how much 1/2 inch tubing, how much 1/4 inch tubing you need, how many emitters, and your connectors, like it was to be a T connector, elbow connector, two terminators. I think I also had a shutoff valve connector. I think I've got one here also, if I need to isolate parts of it. So that was how I did last 2 years, and I made a few upgrades, primarily the way I do my connections, like for the emitters. So like if this is the T-barb, that's the main line. But I did mine this year, like 24 inch line, another T connector, and then two 12 inch lines and an emitter on each end there. So with this system, I've got two emitters per plant, and it gives a little better even coverage and provides some redundancy. And also another change I made, I gave more and more spacing than I have been. What I do now is I've got 36 inch spacing between pairs, and that, because with peppers, if you're growing smaller plants, it's not as big of a deal, but some of the types of peppers can get really large. So as they start growing out, you'll really be glad you gave us more spacing, because it makes, they'll start growing in together and it's hard to tell them apart. So that's a basic overview. And on my system, I actually have on the very end space to add two more pairs, or one pair on each row. So I'm going to show you how I do those and how I punch the holes and make all the connections, just to walk through that, show you how easy it is, and just kind of give you an implementation. I'm also using a vert injector this year too. The first 2 years I didn't use a vert injector, but basically the way it would work is this will be an in, out. So your line come in, go out. So it's basically in line with your drip system. To be the actual injector will be on the bottom, and reservoir nutrients, and this will have a feed tube that sucks this up and then injects that into the stream. So when you're, what's going out to your plants has nutrients. If you don't use that, what I used last 2 years was a just mixing slow release fertilizer into the potting mix. So that way every time I water it, I was also feeding my plants. This year I'm not using slow release fertilizer. I'm just using hydroponic nutrients. I'm actually using DynaGrow 7.5. That's just what I'm trying out this year. Normally I use Master Blend, but this is like an all-in-one solution, so it's a little easier even though it costs a little more. So anyway, let's go ahead and go outside and I'll give you a first-hand look at how my system looks now, and also we'll show you how to install those emitters and the all the connections for that. Okay, this is my drip system. It's kind of a mess now, and the plants are still adjusting, so from transplant, but they're starting to put out new growth, so I think they're fine. And also the nutrient level I'm using was the lowest end, and I'm ramping that up now, so that should encourage more growth and greener leaves. As I said, I upgraded to using a drip system. I have a pressure regulator and a filter here, so I took the one off that I had here that I showed in the diagram. I could probably put the ones I have back here and it'd be okay, maybe a little more extra protection. But for now, I have those off. So this is that little adapter I was telling you about. This is my water hose line, drip line. It's my timer. I got it set to come on every morning at 6 a.m. This connection from the 1/2 inch tube to here is a perma-loc fitting. So that goes to another perma-loc fitting next to the, so he's on to the pressure regulator. goes up through the filter. And this is a bypass assembly. And it's, notice it has shutoff valves. So basically what you could do is route water around your vert injector if you ever needed to take this offline. Or if you just wanted to run just plain water through it. Here's my reservoir of nutrients. And this is the feed tube. So this draws nutrient ups through here. The water comes in, goes into the vert injector there, draws up nutrient solution, injects into the stream here, and comes out, and this goes out to my drip pump, my drip system. And I apologize for the messiness here, but the grass, but this is the perma-loc T adapter. So that's one row, and it continues over here to a perma-loc elbow, and that's my other row. So you can see how I did my drip lines. This is one of the barb tees, and I'll show one of those close up when I hook up the other ones. But this is a quarter inch poly tubing. It goes to another tee, and then there's a line on each end of that that goes to a drip emitter. So I've got a drip emitter on each side of each plant. So I've got room on the end of my lines to do one more pair. This is a terminating cap. It's another perma-loc fitting. So what I'm going to do is get my stuff, and I'm going to install basically one of these on here and show you how exactly how that looks. This is quarter inch poly tubing. And these are my drip emitters. The poly tubing actually connect here, and the water stuff comes out there. So these are the barb T connectors I was telling you about. This one goes into the main line, and then the poly tubing connects on either side. I recommend wearing gloves because it really hurts your fingers. And this is a punch tool. Punches a hole in the main line so the barb connector can connect to. Other thing I recommend is a little tubing cutter. Makes it so much easier. Really works with a quarter inch tubing. I like to keep a piece of tape covering this so no dirt gets up in there until I'm ready to use it. And also I have a tape measure. So I'm first going to measure out two 24 inch pieces and four 12 inch pieces, and that'll give me enough to hook up this end and not have to do this all over again on the other side. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'll be right back. See, that makes it a lot easier. It's actually easier to do this type of stuff inside and just to do a whole bunch of them at once. Oh, another thing, just a tip, when you're laying out your main line, it's good to keep the printed side up, and that way you can kind of use that as a guide where to put your holes, and that way you know they're all kind of along the same side. There's my little punch tool. This is a really cheap one, but it works. Pretty much put it right here on the end. That just pops right down in there. You kind of hear it click. I'll rotate around. And I've got, this is one of my 24 inch lines. Let's take that. See how that just pushes on like that? Same thing with the other one. I need to put the T on each end. It's actually way easier to do inside. It'll hurt your back bending out like this. But That just fits in there. And I've got little 12-inch lines. And again, this is just how I'm doing mine. You could do just one line per plant. Just put the drip emitters. And that's that. And I want to put some tape on the ends of these so they don't get dirt in them, and get the other one done, and then I'm going to get my bag filled up and ready to go. And it'll look just like these when they're installed. Let's see how that goes. Yeah, when I get it installed, I'll turn the drip system on, just let you see how it sounds and looks. But let me get these others done, and I'll be right back. Okay, I only did this pair. I'll do this one later. So he's ready to go. So let's go ahead and turn this on. I've got it set to come on manually, but I mean come on automatically, but you can set it manually to setting that, and then selecting how long you want it to run. And also I installed this back to okay. The clicking sound is the diaphragm pump drawing nutrients up and pushing it through. That's how the emitters look. So we'll take a look at the ones we just installed. Sometimes if they're not leaning forward, it's still dripping, but it just doesn't look like it. Sometimes you just have to, I mean, it's still getting, water's still getting there, but. I like to see the drips come out so I know that it's working. But yeah, so that's that. This is my Mayan pepper, and this is a yellow dystopia. So anyway, that's how I set up my drip system. I hope that was helpful or give you some kind of baseline to work from if you want to design your own. It's only gets as complicated as you make it. It's really doesn't need to be overly complicated. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and please like, comment, and subscribe.